This is Green Wave Hockey on Frontier Community Access Television.
Hi again, everybody. Welcome to Green Wave Hockey right here on FCAT Sports. Lou Bordeaux here with you right now. We're at the College of the Holy Cross in Worcester, Massachusetts. Special one today. This is the state championship game in Division 3A. Greenfield Green Wave against the Lunenburg Blue Knights. A lot to talk about. We're going to have Chris Collins and Todd Howe here in just a moment to take over for the play-by-play. Scouting report on Lunenburg. They play a very similar game to the Belchertown Orioles. You all know that Belchertown has played the Green Wave close over the last few years, so we're expecting a heck of a hockey game here today. We're going to get the starting lineups and the national anthem in just a moment right here on FCAT Sports.
This is Hockey Night in Greenfield, the state Division 3A hockey championships on Bear Country 95.3. Good afternoon, hockey fans. Welcome to the Hart Center at Holy Cross College. Upcoming, the state Division 3A hockey championships, the Greenfield Green Wave and the Lunenburg Blue Knights. Hi again, everyone. This is Chris Collins along with Todd Howe. Albert, Brandy, and Handy, the line to start for Lunenburg, and for Greenfield, the Savoy line centering O'Sullivan and Roach. And we're ready to rock from the Hart Center. The puck is dropped, the game is on, and the faceoff controlled by Lunenburg. Headman pass for Albert into Greenfield territory, stolen by Bauman. That's Kevin. Right wing goes Sullivan, circles back behind his own net, goes left wing looking for Roach. Roach on the near boards, broken up. Now a shot on goal and a save off the steal by Nathan Handy. And Riley Drew covers it up. They'll face it off to his left. Just onto the ice. Centering pass blocked by the defenseman. Lunenburg centering pass again. Now Bauman behind the net. Goes back to the point to McGoldrick. Big hit on Bauman. McGoldrick forces it back down behind the Lunenburg net. And Bauman steals it. Bauman now with it on the left side. Bauman in the slot. Couldn't get a good shot off as he was poke checked by Brandy. And the puck forced down behind the Lunenburg net. It's pushed up the right wing boards, now pushed around by Lunenburg. Roach now trying to slide it in front, turn around, Bauman shot, and a save by Granger right in the breadbasket, and he covers it up with 4:37 to go in period one, and no score.
Nice quick shot from Bauman. He got the pass on his backhand side, spun around. I don't think the goaltender was expecting it, but he certainly was ready once the shot.
And then he wins the draw, back to McGoldrick, slap shot through a screen, deflected wide. Now Bauman pinches, shot, save, rebound loose, backhander by Lenoir, score! Lenoir, 5-hole on the backhander. It's 1-0 Greenfield.
All I can say is what a surprise, because Lenoir was almost going down. I mean, he swung around and threw that backhand, and it was almost like a changeup to the goaltender, and he lunged out to catch it, slid right underneath him. And this line has played well all season. It's great to see them be the first ones. They deserve it. Great play by Lenoir.
First blood drawn, advantage Greenfield, 1-0 Wave. That's Carter now, cycles it, centering pass, shot, score! Bang, bang, just like that, Hunter Arsenal, that one cut part of the pipe and knocked in. It's a power play goal, and it's 1-1.
Unfortunate for Greenfield. I know the coaching staff was doing the right thing, get the player off the ice so there's not an incident. Unfortunately, it led to a bench penalty, but this Lunenburg power play, that was scary good. And I'm not surprised that we're tied up after that power play, and that should be a signal to the Greenfield players. Don't take penalties. Stay out of the box. Let's not give them an opportunity to get this power play back on the ice.
98%, so this is certainly an aberration, but championship game, you've got two teams that are here for a reason, and to take nothing away from Lunenburg here.
What you got to do, though, is get more people in front of Granger, make it tough for him to see some of those shots coming from the slot and the point.
Most definitely. A lot of our game plan is to essentially crash the net and look for the greasy goal, look for the rebounds. Haven't seen that yet, not to say it's not going to happen, but that is the game plan.
30 minutes of hockey to go. Will Greenfield win its first ever state championship? We'll find out soon enough. We are live from the Hart Center at Holy Cross College at the Luff Athletic Complex. 1 minute break, we'll come back. Second period action, Greenfield won, Lunenburg won. It goes back to the point, Carter backhands it to keep it in, and it's skated out by Greenfield. This is Roach through the high slot. Roach, wrist shot just wide of the net. Puck comes all the way around and out of the zone. Now Hunter Arsenal. Jake Bryant chasing it down, pushed behind the Greenfield net. Bryant slams Arsenal to the ice. Big hit there. Here comes Mason Pajari now with it. Up the right wing boards. Tries to slide it in front, goes through everybody, back to the point. Slap shot by Rooney, blocked in front. Rebound loose in the high slot, wrist shot, score! As Jason Brandy got the loose puck in the high slot and roofed it, and it's 2-1 Lunenburg.
Well, I just said, Lunenburg's kind of controlled the play ever since that power play ended for Greenfield. And so for the last 3.5 minutes, it's been all Lunenburg. They're not coming out of their own zone slow. I mean, they're keeping the puck in. And that was another play where they Greenfield really had a couple of opportunities to get it out of the zone, just couldn't do it.
Kevin Bauman shot blocked. And Handy is able to knock it out. Up ahead to Brandy. Shot glove save by Riley Drew. He hangs on. They'll face it off with 5:36 to go in the second.
I'm going to tell you, Greenfield got a break there. I think Brandy, when he grabbed the puck from his own zone, decided, I'm taking the slap shot. And he never saw Matthew Albert going on the other side.
Bauman's out there centering Barnes and Pruzak. Puck forced in by Bryant. In the corner, Pruzak is after it. Back to Bryant. Jake, wrist shot through a screen. Shoots! Loose score! Granger lost sight of it. And it got poked in and we're tied at two.
And the goaltender had it, but from our angle, we could see it just sitting there. And lucky for Greenfield, the referee was in the same corner looking at this loose puck. Barnes jumped all over it.
So it's Prusak that got the goal, not Barnes.
Correct.
Okay, so we had the wrong number. Greenfield has new signs of life. Cross ice pass shot. Oh, what a save by Granger. He robbed Roach. Roach was camp. He slams his stick to the ice. Oh, they don't get much closer than that. Top of the circle with it. O'Sullivan slides it back to McGoldrick at the point. McGoldrick shot, glove saved by Granger. That was labeled. Granger robbed Mike McGoldrick. There the zone, Barnes stands the guy up, drops him down. A lot of tie up there. Now a loose puck, Pruzak now. Drops to Bowie Harris. Harris shot,
Oh,
it almost went in as Granger just got a piece of it. That one had eyes. And they force it out of the zone. Lunenburg trying to hang on. Big hit by Lanois. Now Lanois and Pruzak, Malachi. The play, they went ahead 2-1 on a spectacular goal by Jason Brandy. Took an errant pass, carrying puck in the slot and rifled it over Riley Drew, and a shot that, as Todd House said, was labeled. And then Greenfield was able to get the equalizer when Kyle Barnes, off a shot from Kevin Bauman, which got his way through, it was basically, I don't think Gallant ever saw it. It hit him, it stuck, it sort of spun in the crease, and then Barnes locked it in, and that's where we stand, 2-2.
Yeah, like I said, that's one of those plays where if the defenseman's on the other side of the ice, he thinks the goalie picked it up, he's got the save, he's not going to see that loose puck, but it was right in front of him. And a great opportunity, a great way to kind of get Greenfield get back. And Greenfield really was just lull. They were in a lull, and the lull, like I said, was all in their defensive zone. They're having trouble getting it out, you know. And again, Lanois and Barnes, your two goal scorers, combined height of 10 feet.
Right. And Riley Drew, of course, a strong period. Absolutely no rebounds. That was crucial, I think. You know, they were taking a lot of shots from the point, and Riley's glove hand was equal to the task. I mean, he made a lot of saves in that period and kept Greenfield in it. We're now joined at Mike by the skate doctor, Lou Bordeaux. So Lou, crazy period. It seemed like your guys, after they went down 2-1, kind of pulled back a little bit at 4 Lunenburg. Up to Rossetti on the far wall. Bauman after down. Bauman centering pass, tip by Roach, save, rebound, save again by Granger. Two big saves, second effort, shot in front. Granger lays out and covers. Oh, you don't get much closer than that.
No, tip of the hat to Granger on that one. He made 3 solid saves, 1 with the top of his goalie stick on a rebound. He's getting up slow. He's a little tired after that. Greenfield's best opportunity, and that was a good example. Lunenburg was kind of playing with the puck in the back of the net. Greenfield wasn't being that aggressive, and all of a sudden they turned the aggressiveness on, and they end up getting 3 scoring opportunities. Great play by Greenfield there.
Roach lifts it out to Bauman. Bauman now at center ice. Bauman, high slot. Bauman, shot, score! Brian Bauman! Roofed it! 3-2! Gallant never saw it. It was through a screen. And Greenfield takes the lead with 1:31 to go in regulation.
Wow. Again, we go to the point. Set play. Bryant got the puck in the zone. He just flipped it out to Bauman. He caught it, moved to his right. You know, kind of threw the puck off to the side, skated in. It was 1-on-2. He was all alone, but a screenshot, goalie never saw it. Like I said,
They're at the minute and a half mark. This is their magic minute.
He won the game in overtime against Wakona, and he may very well have won a state championship with that goal. Greenfield fans can smell it. History is about to be made. Puck at the dot. Shot from the point, blocked in front. Forced to the boards. Shot in the middle, now a whistle. Face off to the left of Drew, 35.5 seconds. 6-on-4 for Lunenburg. Puck forced to the boards. It's gut check time for Greenfield. Back to the point. Scrum for it. In the high slot. Slap shot. Saved by Riley Drew. He flies the pad. Rebound goes to the corner. One-timer. Saved by Riley Drew. Glove save with 18.3 seconds left on the slapper by Carter.
Lunenburg's getting their opportunities. You can't take it away from them. But the difference is you got Riley Drew in net. Now here's one other thing with Greenfield. One of the advantages of having that guy in the penalty box, even though it's not really an advantage, at least they can ice the puck.
18.3 seconds. 6-on-4, Lunenburg. Can they get the equalizer?
They have two centermen out there.
Face-off controlled by Greenfield. They flip it out. Just missed the net. No icing. 11 seconds left. Rooney has to come back up all the way to get it. Centering pass through center ice. Bauman now with it. Bryant will skate back in his own end. 2-1. The glass slipper fits. Greenfield wins the Division 3A state championship, beating Lunenburg 3-2. And they're mugging Riley Drew.
Wow. We thought we saw laundry last night. Now we got a rubber chicken on the ice with the laundry. What's nice to see is the coaching staff, huge bear hug for them. They're not coming out to greet the players who have moved the net out of the way, and they are bear hugging again, Riley Drew.
For the first time in the history of the school's hockey program, Greenfield High School is state hockey champions. They defeat Lunenburg 3-2 to win the 3A title. A capper to a glorious season for a great bunch of kids.
Championship medal. I'll tell you, what a performance by Riley Drew in this hockey game. Just a solid, solid game.
You can't ask for anything more today. There were maybe, what, two or three rebounds from him all game?
Correct.
And the glove was on fire. I mean, we've seen some games where the puck might slip out, but the defenseman attack on it. But great job by him. Great job by Bauman.
And a great moment with the coaching staff sort of huddling around together at the blue line. I mean, think about the time these guys put in, too. I mean, you've done it. You know what kind of the commitment it is to coach a high school hockey team. And they've got a full staff of people. The skate doctor, Lou Bordeaux, is down there. He's also been one of our broadcasters on high school hockey broadcasts for Frontier Community Access Television. Mike Duclos, the whole crew, and Adam Bouchard, what a job he has done as the head coach of this hockey program. Now a historic hockey program that is now can call themselves state champions in Division 3A. And the captains go over O'Sullivan, Bauman, Riley Drew, McGoldrick to accept the state championship trophy. They won it in overtime, the Western Mass title Thursday night over Wakona. It looked like it was headed for overtime in this one before Brian Bauman, with a minute and a half left, ripped a shot from the top of the blue line over Granger for the winning goal. And your Greenfield Green Wave, our state Division 3A hockey champions. They're taking the traditional picture on the ice with the trophy in front of them. We are going to take a 90-second break, come back and wrap things up from Holy Cross. Greenfield wins the title. They beat Lunenburg 3-2. This is Hockey Night in Greenfield, brought to you by Gilmore and Farrell Insurance. The Greenfield Green Wave on the ice here at the Hart Center at Holy Cross, skating around with their state Division 3A championship trophy. They defeat Lunenburg 3-2, goals by Lenoy Pruzak and the winner by Brian Bauman. Who else? Mr. Everything. A shot from the top of the blue line that had eyes, and a team of destiny raises the trophy for the first time ever. State Division 3A hockey champions. And these last two, you know, we'll take that to our graves, that memory of just fantastic overtime Western Mass win, and then, of course, the state title win here against Lunenburg. And it was just a great season, and we really appreciate all the support that we've had. For my broadcast partner, Todd Hell, for our studio producer, Dave Reno, I'm Chris Collins. The final score, your Greenfield Green Wave hockey team is the Division 3A state hockey champions in Massachusetts. They beat Lunenburg by a score of 3-2. So long from Holy Cross on High School Hockey, brought to you by Gilmore and Farrell Insurance.
Welcome back to Green Wave Hockey right here on FCAT Sports. Skate Dr. Lou Bordeaux with you. Green Wave state champions. That is never going to get old. We're going to recap the scoring, and then I've got a special surprise here. In the first period, Green Wave got on the board first. Derek Lanois in the slot. Spun around, collected his own rebound, banged it home. We're going to give Kyle Barnes and Kevin Bowman assists on that one. Made it 1-0 Green Wave. Strange turn of events. There was a little bit of a disagreement. Green Wave ended up with a delay of game penalty right off the bat. So shortly thereafter, Hunter Arsenault of Lunenburg managed to get a power play goal, tying the game at 1. And that was how the first period ended. Score was 1-1. Lunenburg scored early in the second period to take a 2-1 lead. Sorry, I didn't get the name of the skater there. With a minute 31 left in the second period, Shane Prusak, and we talked about it on Bear Country, that green line, Shane, Kyle Barnes, Derek Lanois, for the second half of the season, just hard workers. No let up on that one. Jacob Bryant set up Shane Prusak, who buried that one, made it 2-2. And that's where the game stood. Two periods in the books, 2-2. Third period, great back and forth action, up and down the ice. It looked for sure like we were destined for another overtime situation like we saw in the Wakona game a few days ago. But at 13:29 of the third period, Brian Bowman caught a shot, may have caused some damage to his digit there, we hope not. Caught the puck, dropped it down, skated in about 40 feet away, let a one-timer go. Beat the Lunenburg Tendy, high blocker, and well, that was it. 3-2 Green Wave. And to say that the whole team is exhilarated would be an understatement. We're outdoors right now. The team has just gotten on the bus. And at this time, I'm going to call in my special guest. Didn't get a chance to talk to him before the game, head coach Adam Bouchard.
Hey,
coach, never better. I'll tell you what, congratulations on this one. You've got the hardware. What's going through your mind?
Unbelievable. You know, nobody deserves it more than those student athletes on that bus. We walked in that Monday after Thanksgiving with a mission. We told them from day one they were going to work harder than anybody else. And as the season progressed and the season went on, we continued to do so. And when you believe in something and you work hard enough for it, I think we just showed those young men and women that play for the entire Green Wave program that if you face adversity in life and you work hard through it, you do it the Green Wave way, good things will happen. You know, and really, really, really proud of how they performed.
Couldn't agree with you more. It was 97 days ago that 40-some-odd student-athletes hit the ice for the first time, and this was their ultimate goal. Of course, the ones who are the varsity players got to enjoy this, but heck of a turnout by the JV players, helped out with us. I saw a lot of them around the rink surface tonight. So hats off to all of them. I think the program was well represented. This is as good as it gets in our industry.
You know, to all the student-athletes in this program, to all the history in this program. I believe it's about 78 years. We've got a state title now we can raise. I know back in 08, Western Mass Finals was the furthest the team could go.
Yep.
They added another level. We were able to bring it home. And I gotta say, the support that this community has given this hockey program from day one this year, I really appreciate everybody's energy and time that they've given to these student athletes all year long, whether it was at home at the CMA, whether it was on the road, whether it was up in Pittsfield, or down the other end of the state here in Worcester. This community really, really showed its support for these boys and girls. And look it, we did it. We did it.
Adam Bouchard, I'm gonna close out with one thing here. Your first year as head coach of the team, we talked after the season, you said, Doc, I've got a 5-year plan. Here's the results, congratulations, my friend.
5 years later, we did it, didn't we? Go Green.
That's it for this season of Green Wave Hockey on FCAT Sports. I am the Skate Doctor. For Adam Bouchard, the whole staff, we're excited. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you again in December. Good night from Worcester.